Hello friends, today we will begin our fifth chapter of science, that is periodic classification. If you are new to our channel, then please subscribe to our channel. First we will see the necessity of classification. Why it is necessary? It is difficult to study each and every element individually and to know its properties and uses. Therefore they have been classified into groups on the basis of their similarity in properties. Now we will see Dobereiner triads. What are Dobereiner triads? What are its limitations and why it is important? When elements are arranged in the group of three means tri means three, therefore triads in the group of three. In increasing order of atomic masses, the middle element of the group has the atomic mass and properties roughly the average of the other two elements. Three examples are Linacre, Cassara, Culbrath I. It is a short trick to remember this, and their full name is lithium, sodium, potassium, calcium, strontium, barium, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Now we can see that all the elements could not be classified into the triads discovered at that time. At that time 30 elements were discovered, and we can see only 9 elements can fit in the triads. This is the first limitation, and the example is nitrogen, phosphorus and arsenic. This cannot satisfy in the group of triads. Now other limitation is only the limited elements could be arranged in such triads. Now its importance. His classification into triads had a great significance in predicting the atomic mass and properties of the middle elements, that is sodium, strontium and barium. Now we will see Newland law of octave. In this topic also we will see its advantages and limitations. According to Newland law of octave, when elements are arranged in the order of increasing mass, what do you mean by mass? Mass means the sum of proton and nucleus. The property of 8th element will repeat the property of the first, just like the notes of the music. In the notes of the music also we can see that sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni and again sa. In the same way in this also he made a law that in that law all the elements will repeat the property of the first. Then, therefore this is known as law of octave, and since Newland has invented it, so it came to be known as Newland's law of octave. Now we will see the limitations of Newland law of octave. First is his octave was applicable only up to calcium, means 40 mass. He assumed that only 56 elements will exist in nature and no more element will be discovered. But future there are many elements that were discovered whose properties cannot fit in the law of octave. He also adjusted two elements in the same slot and also put unlike elements under the same knot. That's the great disadvantage of Newland's law of octave. An example is cobalt and nickel and iron. In this, cobalt and nickel are same in properties and are placed in same slot and are placed in same column also. And iron, chlorine and bromine, which have different properties. Iron, which resemble cobalt and nickel, have been placed far away from these elements. Last is, at the time of discovery of noble gases, it was difficult to place them in the law of octave. Therefore, the law of octave did not work for the lighter elements. Next is Mendeleev periodic law. At that time, 63 elements were discovered. First is the law of Mendeleev. He stated that the properties of the chemical elements are the periodic function of their atomic masses. This you can learn. Now his achievements. He left some gaps for yet to be discovered elements. He also predicted the properties of the undiscovered elements and thus help in the discovery of these elements later on. He named them in the prefixing a Sanskrit numerical. Example is Ika Boron. With his classification, the atomic mass of some elements was corrected, for example gold. Now the limitations. Position of hydrogen. The most difficult task for him was the position of hydrogen. Most of the properties of hydrogen are similar to the halogens, that is chlorine and bromine. But he placed them in the group of alkali metals, that is the first group. Position of isotopes. This is the second challenge. It was difficult to place isotopes in the proper manner. Now we will see modern periodic law. Properties of the chemical elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers. Last there was atomic masses and now atomic numbers. Characteristics of modern periodic table. There are 18 vertical columns called the groups and 7 horizontal columns called periods. Now I will explain you the periodic table with the help of a chart. In that there are 18 vertical columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. And 7 periods, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In this first period, there are 2 elements, 1 and 2. In the second and third period, there are 8 elements. Fourth and fifth period, there are 18 elements. And in the sixth and seventh period, there are 32 elements. Here, rest are here. Now, the first group are called the alkali metals. Second group called the alkali earth metals. 17th group is called halogens. And 18th group is called noble gas. Now, as we move down in the group, the number of shell will increase. Shell will increase. And the radius will also increase. Therefore, the size is also increasing as we move from up to down in a group. Now, as we move down in the group, the metallic character also increase. And since the metallic character is also increasing, the non-metallic character will obviously decrease. And valency will remain same. There is no change in the valency. For example, hydrogen has a valency of 1. Lithium also 1. Sodium also 1. And calcium also 1. All have a valency same in a group. Now, as we move from left to right, in a periodic, nuclear charge will increase. Charge will increase, then the atomic radius will decrease and obviously the size will decrease. As also we move from left to right, the metallic character will decrease, and as the metallic character will decrease, the non-metallic character will increase. Next is, as we move from left to right in the period, first the valency will increase and then it will also decrease and finally zero. Thank you. Hope that you liked the video. Please like and share the video with your friends. And please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.